Okay, good morning everybody. Myself K. Rajeshwar, ZPSS Dornakal, Mandal Dornakal, School Assistant Physical Science, Mohabad Education, Mohabad District. So today we are facing lot of problems due to COVID-19 in the education system. So our Mohabad District and Mohabad District technical team developed a platform, video lessons by the guidelines of DOs or Mohabad District. So today I am going to discuss about hydrocarbons, 10th class physical science. Carbons. So carbon is an important element in the life. So carbon is a mixing of all the materials. In every material, carbon element is there. In the cloth, carbon is there. In the board, carbon is there. In the paper, carbon element is there. In the book, carbon element is there. So due to this various enormous large combination in the materials, the scientists decided to separate the carbon as a separate chapter. So organic chemistry. So for the 10th class students, they have chemistry of carbons, carbon and its compounds in the last chapter, 12th chapter. So in this carbon, the electronic carbon atomic number is 6. The carbon atom covalency is 4. Electronic configuration of carbon atom is equal to 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. So carbon, so today hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons means the compounds which are having the combination of hydrogen and carbon atom. So the combination of hydrogen and carbon atoms are defined as the hydrocarbons. Example, methane, propane, butane, etc. So for example, methane means CH4. In the methane, you have the carbon and the hydrogen element. So also carbon have the allotropy forms. Allotropy forms means an element which are having one or more forms is defined as the allotrope. The allotropic forms of carbon atom are graphite, diamond and Buckminster fullerenes. So in the hydrocarbons, we have 3 categories. Basing on the properties of hydrocarbons, they categorize into 3 types. So hydrocarbons means they categorize 3 types: alkanes, CnH2n+2. Alkenes, general form of alkenes, CnH2n, and alkynes, the general formula of alkynes is CnH2n-2. So in the alkanes, they are named as saturated hydrocarbons. In the alkanes, we have single bond structure. Okay, we have single bond structure. See, example, alkanes means which are having single bonds between carbon and hydrogen atoms. So example, methane, you take methane, CH4, carbon and hydrogen. The structure of methane is CH4. So carbon, 4 hydrogens, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can observe the 4 hydrogen atoms here. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you have single bonded. So whereas the covalence of carbon atom is how much? 4. So it satisfied here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Another example, ethane, C2H6. Ethane. Okay. C2H6. 2 carbons and 6 hydrogens are there. So each carbon have satisfied covalency. How much? 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also covalency. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is an example, ethane. It is an example of alkane. The general formula of alkane is CnH2n+2. Okay. Now, so Next, alkenes. Alkenes means unsaturated hydrocarbons. Unsaturated hydrocarbons again category into two types: double bond and triple bond. In unsaturated hydrocarbons, we have two types: alkenes and alkynes. Okay, alkenes and alkynes. So, unsaturated hydrocarbons. Unsaturated hydrocarbons are categorized into two types. They are alkenes and alkynes. Alkynes. So alkenes. Alkenes means the elements, the hydrocarbons which are having double bond. In the alkenes we can face double bonds. Double bonds. In the alkenes we can face the structures triple bonds. Triple bonds. Now these two categories are unsaturated hydrocarbons. Unsaturated, S-A-T-U, unsaturated hydrocarbons. Okay, these are unsaturated hydrocarbons. In the alkenes we can observe the double bond. And in alkenes we can observe the triple bond. So double bond example, hydrocarbons are alkynes is a double bond example. Alkynes. In the alkynes we can observe the triple bond. So double bond example, methane, propene. Okay, general form of alkenes is CnH2n. Okay, general form of alkenes is CnH2n. See, general formula of alkene is CnH2n. General formula of alkynes is CnH2n-2. So this is a simple formula. By remembering these general formula of hydrocarbons, we can write any number of hydrocarbons. Okay, CnH2n. CnH2n is the general formula of alkenes. To write any alkene, use this general formula. Example, you take N=4. C4H2. This is the compound is called butene. This is an example of alkene. This is called butene. Now, whereas in alkynes, general formula is CnH2n-2. The general formula of alkenes is CnH2n-2. So this is the general formula. For example, if you take 4-5 here, C5H2 10-2, 8. Propyne, pentyne. The name of this is pentyne. Ine will be there. So suffix, you need the suffix. So CnH2n-2 is the general formula of alkyne. Example we are seeing here, pentyne. Okay, in the alkynes you can take triple bond. Alkynes are an example of triple bonds. And that one, now the general structure, you see the structure of alkynes. We will see the structure of alkynes. What is the structure of alkynes? There, for example, you take, okay, now you see structure of butane example. So this is butane is an example of alkane. Alkanes means generally what we can understand, that alkanes means the compounds which are having single bonds in the structure, in the between two atoms, carbon, between carbon and hydrogen atom. So take a structure of butane, C4H2. So here you have carbon bond. So how many hydrogens are there in this butane C4H2? 10 hydrogens are there. You have to mark the 10 hydrogens between carbon atoms. So hydrogen. See here, the carbon, the what is the carbon covalency? Carbon covalency is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So each carbon atom should satisfy the covalency property. Covalence, how much the carbon atom covalence is? 4. See here, 4 are there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also in this carbon you have 4 four covalents. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4. What about this carbon? 1, 2, 3, 4. So in everywhere, each carbon attains four covalency property. Four covalency is there for carbon atom. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the structure of C4 ester, butane. Example of alkane this is. Okay, alkane, butane. Butane, you see, this is butane. So, this is single bond example. Okay, thank you very much. This is the general about hydrocarbons. Next class, we will continue the other topic. Thank you.